and welcome to BCA News. I'm Grace Park.
And I'm Emily Sen. Here are our top stories for tonight. Our top story tonight, South Korean President Moon Jae-in is in Washington, D.C. for an important first meeting with U.S. President Donald Trump. The main issue that will be discussed is how the United States and South Korea will cooperate in dealing with North Korea. While the U.S. President has maintained an aggressive posture towards the North, responding to their recent claims by the North that they're in the final stages of developing a nuclear missile by saying it won't happen, the newly elected Korean President has pledged to engage with the North diplomatically and has suspended the deployment of four missile launchers in the THAAD defense system. For more on this story, our correspondent Tom Park is in Washington. Tom, what can you tell us about how President Trump is likely to respond to President Moon's scale back of the THAAD defense system?
Hi Emily, Trump was reportedly furious over Moon's decisions to suspend the launchers, as Washington's position is that the missile defense system is necessary to protect not only South Korea, but also the more than 30,000 U.S. troops stationed in the country.
How are Moon's policies going to affect South Korea's relationship with China and the U.S.?
Good question, Emily. While former President Park Geun-hye made it clear to China that South Korea was committed to deployment of the missile system, resulting in standoffs between the two countries, President Moon's suggestion of a renewal of the Sunshine Policy with North Korea may be good news for China.
Our second story today comes from Brazil, where President Michel Temer has been formally accused of corruption by Attorney General Rodrigo Janot. This is the first time a Brazilian president has faced criminal charges while in power.
Our chief Latin America correspondent Peter Sa is in Bogota, Colombia, where FARC rebels have completed the disarmament process. Peter, what can you tell us about the significance of this?
Emily, this is a war that's been going on for over 50 years and has left over a quarter of a million people dead. The former fighters are now due to make a transition into civilian life, and the organization as a whole will transform into a political party. For Vision News, I'm Peter Saw.
We now turn to sports with Ian Kim. Ian, what's going on to the world of sports today?
Hi Grace, North Korea has rejected a proposal made by the South Korea President Moon Jae-in for the two countries to form a unified team at next year's Pyeongchang Olympics. South Korea's sports minister Do Jung-hwan had suggested a joint ice hockey team and the possibility of the North hosting skiing events, but North Korean IOC member Chang Eun dismissed the idea, saying there was no time to negotiate a deal.
And the winner of the 2017 Kia NBA Most Valuable Player Award is Russell Westbrook.
Russell Westbrook of the Oklahoma City Thunder took home the Most Valuable Player Award after averaging a triple-double for the whole season, something no player has done since Oscar Robertson in 1962.
Now it's time for our weather forecast. Esther, how are things looking this week?
To be honest, Emily, not good. We probably won't be seeing the sun very much until next weekend, as we are likely to rain and thunderstorm throughout the week. Don't forget your umbrella if you go out.
Thank you, Esther. And now our last segment before the break. Let's take a look at the traffic. We've got our chief traffic correspondent, Caleb Kim, up in Chopper 1. Caleb, how are things looking down there?
Grace, you probably want to take the metro this evening because the traffic is moving less than my great-great-grandmother, and she has been dead since 1922. The reason for the stoppage is a truck carrying pigs that overturned. The pigs seem to be safe as they are making their way in the opposite direction through the cars. Maybe a couple lucky commuters will grab a pig or two for dinner.
almost wish I was caught in some of that traffic. Samgyeopsal sounds great right now. That's all the news for today. Thank you for watching. I'm Lee Sun.
And I'm Grace Park. Thank you for watching Village Christian News.